Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to another episode of Jocch's Playbook, episode 3. Tonight we're drinking box wine from Trader Joe's. We're going to be watching Astralis versus Team Liquid from iBuyPower Masters Grand Finals, Map 1 on Inferno. Specifically, I want to welcome Rick Banff, and we're going to be taking a look at how Astralis plays Banana. So they have a little bit of a kind of a different take on how they want to do it. They're a little bit more aggressive than other teams, but they seem to have a very good thought process behind it. And it takes Liquid a long time to figure out exactly what Astralis is doing before they kind of put the pieces together. And this is going to be a pretty dominating half for Astralis. And I won't spoil the series for you, but it was a really great series. This is a not an exciting map, but we're going to take a look at what they do on the CT side, specifically at B. And we are just going to go right into it. I got my notes ready. I got my phone on vibrate over there. And we're going to get right into it. All right, here we go. So, just around, CT side. And we are just going to take a look at how they do this. So, they're going to start... We're going to start pissing around with three people at B. And kind of the theme to them playing Banana is going to be super aggressive. You're going to find that they're going to be consistently a guy at Sandbag and a guy at Car. And they are not giving, they're not going to give you Banana easily. They're not going to let you get Car. They're not going to do anything. But this aggression on CT side is how they want to approach it. So we have Zimfix, Glaive, and Device here on the pistol round. And there's going to be not a whole lot of action early until they start peeking down. So they're just looking for information. Kind of take a look here. Liquid's going to be stacked. He gets a flash in. Then they find two quick frags. So them pushing down Banana gives them now pretty much full map control. They obviously get lucky with a TK in there. And now they pretty much have a dominating position on Banana and the round. So we're just going to watch Glaive. We'll finish this round out. This is it. They lose the bomb. Now it's a 4-on-1. All said and done. So in the second round, their first pseudo gun round, you're gonna see pretty much what they're gonna do every round. So they're gonna send two people B pretty consistently, and you're gonna see this double molly action. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna quarter speed, resume, we're gonna go like this. You're gonna consistently see this whole game, this double molly action. One close, one far. And that's smoke. This is consistently, this is what they want to run, this is what they think is the best, it's what they do on a consistent basis. So it's going to be interesting to see how this half develops and what Liquid does to kind of respond, and they take a little bit too much time to figure out what's going on. So there it is. They're going to be aggressive, they're going to consistently be out here. We want to watch Zimfix for this round. So obviously in the pistol round, you got the complete total monetary advantage. You got the utility, you got the guns, very simple. So. This deep smoke allows Glaive to get really close to Mexico, or whatever they call mid pit, T-ramp. He's just spotting, and he can hear everything going on. So if we just switch to Glaive, he can hear them running up mid, he can hear them coming back. He's got a bunch of information. He just starts lighting people up. And Zimfix, obviously with a huge gun advantage, pulls down B. This is what they want to do on their gun rounds and anti-eco rounds. This is it. Obviously we got Stu left. In a terrible situation, and he's gonna get cleaned up. So there's not much left in that round. So again, we're going to see how them liquid forcing the second round is going to kind of push back their buy to the next. We're gonna watch our boy. So with them pushing down banana and getting full control of the actual banana part, the people playing mid and A know that if they cannot get into banana, we have a chance to peek into mid and maybe get frags. Obviously, again, with the gun advantage here, they're going to try and take advantage of this and get some kills. Liquid is stacked up at T-Ramp. Everyone at A is going to be super aggressive because they know they have the gun advantage. Double nade down mid. And here's your boy Majisk. Just gonna unload on people. Easy, right? And then I think Zimp gets this. Nope. Liv. Liv's gonna find a guy through the smoke. Dupree gets last kill. And now we're gonna see the first real gun around here. So now, you're going to see Astralis go back to the 3B early. And they're going to move to 3A. So they just show pressure early here. Want to be looking at our boy, Blade. Ooh. Or no. Round will be in 4. You want to be on... So Dupree's this guy who's gonna rotate off. So, oh boy, here's what we want to be doing. So they've already thrown their double molly. Hopefully we can still catch it. Oh, we just missed it. So they've thrown their double molly. They've thrown their deep smoke. If Liquid had been paying attention on their gun rounds, they know like, okay, they're pushing some guy here. Banana's probably pretty closed right now. And then the key to this round is going to be our boy Zinfix, I believe. So let's continue. Huh? Liquid, what Liquid is going to eventually figure out in this game is they need to retake banana late. Their early pressure and double mollies and smoking deep banana, Astralis just has so much free reign on the map. And this is where they're going to play. Zinfix and Glaive play banana outside of the site for the entire game. I think there's very few times where they want to be playing on the inside. Obviously, as the rounds progress and, okay, they've lost the map control, they're going to back up into the site. But this is how a lot of the rounds start. So now, Glaive is just going to do this for the remainder of the round. And since he knows, hey, we still have full B control and I haven't seen a soul, it allows, allows for them to know that, hey, they're leaning A. See? Glaive sees nothing. He's telling everybody, I don't see anything yet. I don't see anything yet. He's just gonna keep doing this. And when he feels a little unsafe, which is ooh, now, throws his flash. They've already got a guy on the way. Zinfix is on his way. But still, 40 seconds to the round, they don't need to make this call. Like, hey, we need a guy. They still have 5 players. It's 5-on-4. They're going to take their body advantage. And then here's something I want to note on the T side. So, notice the time. We're deep in a round. And Liquid's slowly creeping up B. So, obviously, we've played matchmaking where people throw the cheapest, lamest fakes ever, and sometimes they work, and most of the time they don't. But look, if we're 20 seconds in a round, or 20 seconds remaining in a round, you see one, two, three pieces of utility come in unique. Don't look at that one. Three pieces of unique succession? Hey, it's probably going to be here. So not only do they get a good hold, but there's people already on the way. So Dupree was already pretty much running when this was happening. Oh, and now has no chance of winning this round. See, it's cool stuff, huh? Cool stuff. Oh, we went too fast. Hold on, I can't find my mouse. Sorry. Sorry about that. Sorry about that. Holy cow, it happened again. Round. Nine. So, one time. Let's see, what are we? Fifth round, five. Boom. So we want to go back. What? No? There it is. We're going to be back on our boys Zimfix and Glaive, who play B together. What we got? They're going to be aggressive at car again, and we want to watch Glaive to start. Here he is. Half speed, resume. So boom. They're going to have their aggressive double molly, nade look. He throws his deep smoke. And now we want to watch Zimfix. Already out here. Super mollied off. Alish is actually going to get caught in the second molly. He's going to be blind. But there's no chance of getting to me. No chance. There's just so much map control. There's nothing you can do about it. So Glaive is now back in his position where he can hear T-Ramp. He can hear Mexico. He can hear anything coming up and down mid. So much information. So much information. So now, I mean, look where Liquid is in the map. We have a guy in window room. We have a guy deep T ramp, practically T spawn. We have Stu stuck here. And you have Twist outside of T upstairs. Not a whole bunch of information. Not a whole bunch. So now, Liquid's like, okay, well, we have to get some sort of control. Babe's gonna be right here. He hears everything coming. He reacts like a god right here. So, Zimp throws this smoke, and now he's back down banana. He can hear everything. He's gonna get lucky here. He's gonna find a fryer. Switch to this while I hold my wine. Boom. We want to watch our boy Dupree. Now we're 4-on-2. Nitro's going to get one entry, but we have 40 seconds on the clock. Dupree's in a pretty decent spot. And Liquid has one smoke. One smoke in the bank. Taste. They use their smoke, they're gonna walk up port side. Dupree hears a footstep, says they're here, ends the round. Easy day. Not double peeking. Easy, easy, easy stuff. Easy, good Counter-Strike, boys. Alright, so Liquid is gonna eco here. Obviously, they haven't had luck anywhere. Banana's been 100% closed. They haven't had any luck at mid. They walk up A, they get smoked. So what do you do? What do you do? I'll tell you what you do. Try something crazy. But even though you try something crazy, they're gonna eat all that. Double molly. Okay, so something we need to talk about real quick. So, they've thrown their double molly, they've seen a lot of B. So what does our boy Device do, knowing that it's a save round? He's gonna peek mid. if he peaks mid, knowing that if they've committed B, now he has the whole cutoff. Now he's got a bunch of information. Now he can tell his whole team they can't be mid. And why this is even better is now you have Majisk, who's kind of on a flank. He sees it's clear, he's just going to take off. They have so much information. It's not necessarily what you see, but you don't see. Perhaps just press a little bit. Glaive and Zimfix do a good job of helping each other out here. And oh, I went to go to Dupree. So it gets slightly hairy at the end, but Dupree's there to clean it up. Alright, round 7, where are we at? Okay, this is actually a really interesting round here. Number one, I think they talk this round. No, they just have a timeout. And I want to talk about some stuff. Hold on, we want to go to Zimfix. They're going to do their stand. They do this every round. They mix up the mollies. But you just heard one molly get extinguished, right? Your boy Stewie2K figuring it out. But what he does is Stu throws this smoke himself. You can see the little line there. That stops the molly. He catches the molly, now he's got a little bit more control on B. So, I mean, he doesn't have a whole bunch more space, but closer than he was. Belige, I believe, is going to follow him. And now Liquid's kind of figured out, okay, if we want B, we either got to be aggressive with smoke, or we got to take it late. And here's what they do. Throw the smoke. Who's going to have a little bit more control. Glaive is going to get kind of cut off here. He runs through, does a little jump. And now Liquid have control banana. So guys, adjustments. While this is all going on, this is all going on today. It was a little interesting. I didn't catch this the first time I watched it, but they were stacked up in apps pretty heavily. So, Liquid gets control of Banana. They have a little bit more map presence. They can back off, do whatever they want. What they decide to do, they're going to try and get some control of A. But I happen to walk on the side where they all are, which is a little bit unlucky. So now we have a lot of time left. The bomb down, I think, in Mexico. And, you know, a little bit of utility left on that. Well, the way this round plays out is actually pretty interesting. And Twist is going to have a super insane play towards the end. But let's watch Zimfix on the entry, or we'll watch Glaive. He'll see him first, so we'll go to Glaive. Again, we're low time and around. They know there's only three people left. And they throw the utility. And it's probably going to be here. So, there's going to be a couple things that happen here that I want to take a look at a couple times. So we're going to play it at half speed. Actually, no, we'll play it one time through regular. So the boy we're going to watch is actually Majisk. So Majisk is on the flank. Here's my issue with his play. They should know it's a 2-on-2. And I think somebody miscommunicates or Majisk got caught up or something happens because the way this all goes down is just goofy. So play like this. Majisk is going to be flanking through B. And you have device through T-spawn. The device doesn't know anything. Except if it's a 2-on-2. But now Device should be yelling at Majisk, like, hey man, he's right here. On the way in, back up correctly. Way in. Play half speed. Taste, two, half. So Majisk is going to get this first kill as we just saw. Easy peasy. Device is going to hear Twist. Hears him. But Majisk ends up pulling out this Molly. And I don't know why. Ends up having it in his hand at like the complete wrong time. So Twist ends up just blowing his brains out. So he's going to get this kill. But now I want to watch from this angle and watch how smart Twist plays this. Twist knows, like, okay, he can't be the same. So we'll speed this up. We want to watch our bull. Twist. Boom. They get set, right? Okay, they get the ball on the planet. Half gets a kill, 2-on-2. Well, now we're gonna see a lot of that stuff play out again, right? Just gets the kill. Shortly. Twist makes noise. He realizes he's getting baited. He shoots him in the face real quick, which is genius. And then all I have to do is play the bomb. I just think that, unfortunately, Charles misplayed right there. Twist obviously has a big brain play, but just a small misplay out of Astralis. Something must have happened there because it's very un-Astralis like of them. Okay, where are we at? Round 8. So, now we need to watch our boy Stu, who's unfortunately having a pretty difficult time here. 0-1-7. They start talking about some stuff. This is actually kind of funny. There's a helicopter in my ears. And Naf is going to jump in. Drinks. Bucket. What a boss. Blaze's like, dude, can't hear shit, bro. I like they're going through two of each headsets. And then Dupree, we're already at the after party. It's quite unique. What a ball. Speed up a taste. Alright. So Liquid must have some sort of idea what they want to do with Banana, because Stu is going to be the linchpin here. He's going to throw this Molly, he throws his smoke. I shouldn't say linchpin, he's just kind of the brains. At least he's the person executing all this. So, I mean, they have the idea, right? Because here's a Liege. And I should say, in all this, they have the right idea, they just failed to execute here. They failed to execute. Rick Banff, you should join Liquid, bro. So, this is just kind of a funny turn of events. Leech is going to push. Glaive hears it. He's just actually trying to get the op, and it just doesn't work out. And so now, we've got chaos, right? Liquid take B. We are in a 3-on-2. In round 8. Got it. Trying to get my notes, make sure I don't miss anything this round. And the real thing to take out is now, okay, this aggression has finally kind of not worked at B. Their last round doesn't really count because they took it deep in the side, so a little bit different methodology there. But now let's see how they play it. So Majisk is by himself here. He's going to hear him come up. And somehow, nobody looks here. This one. Math is gonna fake this plan, I believe. Oh. Oh, he gets blown away right there. And the round's over. So as you kind of saw, Liquid is starting to figure out what's going on at Banana. Seeing this hyper-aggressive defense out of Astralis. Getting their double mollies in. They're getting the late smoke here. And they're constantly peeking from car, trying to get to this position, because they can hear everything going on here. Not only can they hear everything, if something does happen to shoot up A, they can rotate. So they find this spot to be very helpful here. That takes us to round 9. And I think this round is going to be pretty lame, as far as what we're trying to learn. Here. There. And there. Actually, you know what? I think it's, yeah. Sick 1D. I think it's his face taken off. And you see a whole lot of this kind of eco stuff. Looks like they're just kind of playing for a pick. Leash kind of hears what's going on. There's not too much in this round that you need to think about. At least when it comes to B. We'll just kind of enjoy it for what it is. Take any other notes in this round? No, I just said Liquid broke and there's no contest to B. So it sounds like they're going to go in. Yeah, Zymph is holding a super tight angle. The AUG is just so good right now. Taxing people up. Easy. 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 I guess let's just kind of watch this again. Because Zymphix does do something that a lot of people... Did do something that a lot of people did the opposite of. Right moment. A lot of people want to repeat this. Come on. Oh, we're way too far. Way too. What the hell happened here? 8 round 9? That's what we want. I don't know. You watch Nath. Runs up mid. Paste it. He gets his place blown off. Got him. Then kind of a leash hops around. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Then we got Zymphix coming back to Arch. Yeah. Holds a tight angle. Oh, actually pretty smart. Grabs the gun. Look at that. Look at that genius play. Then he holds a super tight angle. Okay, and... Alright. He's holding a super tight angle, and you see people constantly do two things. They shoot, they do some damage, and they rip out a nade. I'm just gonna nade. The second guy comes around the corner and one digs you or whatever. Or takes the first angle, like, oh sweet, and then he peeks and then he gets his face blown off. But he knows that we have Dupree. Yeah, I believe Dupree's gonna come to library. We'll resume this. Does some damage. Dupree's gonna rotate. Zim doesn't peek, he just lets the guy come. Gets his first kill. Dupree gets the second guy. Just gets the last guy. So Zim does a really good job not re-peeking and letting kind of Dupree take some aggro from him and then take another peek after that. Easy game, right? Round 10, Liquid still broke. I got no notes in this round. I don't even remember what they did. It's been a hell of a week, boys. They go, hey, we don't got anything. We are not going B. almost does the same thing at B. They threw their double mollies. That's why you don't see anybody there. This stew's down here. Yep. I didn't write down where they went this round. So we're just gonna enjoy it for what it is. Oh, zip. Device is best to help him out. Happened there. I want a 3-on-2. Trying to remember what happens here. I don't think anything, actually. I think they lose this round again. Yeah, they both died to the molly. Yeah, he's gonna die right here. Whoop! By the way, it just goes to show you how strong double pit is late, especially if they have map control on A. Double pit's incredible. Okay, here we go. Round 11. Round 11. We're gonna see something else in their playbook. I think they call on Dupree. Yep. They send 3B. So if you thought double wall wasn't enough, here it is. They throw the deep smoke, they throw the mollies. Bang bang. Perhaps. And he just loops. That's it. Maybe they think they have a read there. I'm not sure why they decided to do it there. I'm just trying to take some information out of it. But obviously they feel like if they can shut down banana, they're gonna shut down liquid. But I also think that this is the round they start to figure it out. I think they neglect liquid neglects B early. But I see Stu just kind of deep here. Now they're coming back. But you're gonna see, I believe, somebody flash over. They just dry peek this. Yeah, here it is. Get back in. So Glaive feels like he's in trouble, so he's calling for the rotate. The other side of the map. They feel like they have strong positions here. You're gonna see Glaive get stuff. Die. And then you see Zip come in and just mow people down. Easy peasy. They see device whiff. You have Naf and a 2-on-1. So a reasonable position if you're liquid here. When your guys who's playing incredible right now, you have 1-on-2 with the bomb down. Feel like you have a chance. However, hey, don't forget, you're playing the best team in the world. I believe Dupree comes in here and finishes him off. Hey, look at that. Such a sick flashbang too. Astralis, man. They're incredible. We need to take a moment to just see like how brutal it actually was. Like, nobody fragged. Not a whole lot of ADR. Super, like, not doing anything with utility. It's just rough for Liquid. Just rough. But such is Counter-Strike. Such is the game. Heat up a taste. Where are we on? Round 12. We got here. Oh. So the past two episodes we kind of talked about looks of like whether you're on T side or T side, like, hey, if we show this look, they might think it's this, or hey, if we show this, they might believe it's that. So you're gonna see Astralis essentially know that, like, they're not gonna come B. They haven't had any success in an early round trying to do it. They haven't done a whole lot of fast stuff early round outside of their pistol round where they got clobbered on B kind of sort of. So let's worry less about B if we feel like we've established dominance over there. So they're going to call for a little bit of a change. So they're going to start this round. They're going to start this round with 3B. They stack the utility over there. They throw their mollies. B. Majisk hits down here. And they're showing like aggressive main control. Now that they have it, I'm out. Blade is just gonna peek. And now they send 4A. They feel like, hey, we don't have to worry about B, they're not gonna do it. Let's worry about A. So they have this just super sick positioning. And Liquid is walking right into it. Liquid's walking right into everything. They walk into the buzzsaw. And he finds it and gives himself a chance, right? Like, here's the thing. You can make all the right calls you want calling games. Like, they Astralis clearly made the right decision here, like sending 4A, like faking all their B pressure and putting a guy A. Like, 100% the right decision. It just sometimes doesn't work out, which is unfortunate. But now Stu knows everything, right? So how's he play 1-on-1? He's got a pre-fire in. Zim thinks he has him right here too. He's like, I'm just gonna run over there. Oh, psych. Now you're one with the bomb down. Now you have a really good chance of winning the round. Like, this is just a lot of individual play right here. I know everything. Easy. Ooh. So unfortunately, we're in round 13, and Liquid has got B figured out a little bit. So Astralis is on a little bit of low money. Still have enough to scrap together to buy. Obviously, Dupree's got the swag 7. And they're going to start 3B again. But, go back. You're going to see Liquid makes their adjustment. Clearly too late in the half, but regardless, they make their adjustment. Zoom, close here. We have Liquid, or excuse me, we have Astralis with their 3B. They're going to throw their mollies, we know this. And a Liege going to throw one flashbang. They are pretty much not challenging B very hard. Like, they're gonna wait, they know what they're doing. Okay, the Leech feels like he's safe. There's no real contest here, right? There's like, okay, well, let them throw their stuff, let's retake it, let's just play retake on banana. As you can see, Magisk is rotating off, so now there's two of B. Excuse me. Liv and Zimp. So now here comes. There it is. Now here comes Liquid. Kind of like, alright, we're ready to come back through. We'll take it now. Now we got a chance. 3-on-2, utility is pretty much nullified. Like, a lot of the utility was for naught. Just this big contest. On 13, we want to be watching our boy play. Because he's going to try and push down and get this position. Oh boy. He's going to get blown away. Now it's just on Zinfix. Alright, so now you can see Liquid start to change the pace up a little bit, figure out what they're doing. Okay, now we have control of Banana. They have at least one there. Now what do? We just retake it. Like, look, it's ours now. They show, hey, we got B control. We're just gonna kind of hold here for a second. On 13. And so now you can see how Liquid makes a mid-game adjustment. See what they're doing. Astralis, in my opinion, telegraphs their hand too much. They just kind of, we're just gonna run this. It's not necessarily completely optimal, especially if they don't run down B. If they don't run down B, you just wasted two mollies and did zero damage. So, does it make more sense to do something different from time to time? Yeah, probably. If you just keep showing that same look, it's like, okay, guys, just wait a second. Okay, now let's take it. So, I think it's probably in Astralis' best interest to mix in a different look here, Banana. I don't know if that means nades, what that means, but I guess you do pre. Get clobbered here because he's got a swag. Boom. And now it's a 4-on-2. And Liquid's gonna get the bomb plant. Bomb has been planted. And they're not gonna go for it. Money's low. I don't got great. Don't have great money. Easy save call. So let's not bore you with it. So, see a little bit of a force here from Astralis. Start with the boy Zimp. There he is. Up a little bit. So Astralis is going to force here. Round 14. They're feeling it. They feel like we have enough rounds. Let's take a little bit of risk. Let's gamble. Rip it. They're going to do their 3B again. For me, it's interesting to think they did 3B, I think like 2 or 3 rounds in a row. 4 rounds in a row. Let's do the 4th round in a row, they do 3B. And they're going to continue with the aggression, even though the Zimp runs through Molly. He's just going to rip face. He gets traded. Now we need to watch a board. Ooh! Device. So, Device uncharacteristically misses a lot of shots here. I mean, by a lot, I mean two. They misses those. Now we got our boy Dupree. Or, oops, Clay. Gonna catch one. Blinded. And now the round kind of comes some sort of parody. But as you can see, Astralis is really gunning down B every round. Finds one. Awesome. Round 15. Alright. So, half speed, close, this. So as we've learned this half, Astralis is hyper aggressive on defending B. Very few times are they not out here. Actually, that's one of their mollies. There's the native logs. Who's gonna fight back? Well, Charles gets, or Elias gets one. Now I have banana control. As you can kind of see, it's been pretty consistently the same look at banana. Hey, we're gonna be aggressive. We're gonna throw a lot of utility, and then it's up to you. So liquid just kind of waits. Says fine, throw what you gotta throw. We'll take it back. And this is definitely not the best showing of liquid on Inferno. I hope to see better of it, especially with the Dren and Stew. This is what we get. We get so early in the year. They're gonna show a lot of this like beat pressure, like hey, we're here. Fall off. Holds. This is where you kind of see it. Liko's gonna throw like the commitment here. Like three, here's a lot of what's going on. Finds the first one. And here's where Twist is gonna sell this. Gets a first incredible kill and then hits this one. You dirty dog. But look at what he did. What he does. And this is the problem with people like, oh, I'm gonna throw a fake. Throwing grenades is not a fake. Like, it's like the Walmart fake. So he's obviously just got that first skill. Slow it down. Oh, too far. Holy. Majisk is already rotating, is what I'm saying. By getting that kill, Twist is selling the fake. He gets this one. If you watch it super slow-mo, just watch how dope this is. Hear him breathing. Click. But now the fake is sold. They're in trouble. He obviously loses this gunfight, but it doesn't matter because Majisk is already like, dude, I'm coming. Don't worry about it. I'm on my way. And here's that. He's gonna see the smoke. And now they know. So with Elige and Nitro here, I think Liquid has a phenomenal chance of winning this round. Right? Both great players. Both veterans, both know how to get the job done. However, it's not going to play out like that. Nitro is scared a little bit, as I would be too. Like, bruh. Just comes out here, kills him. Now he knows, okay, I know where you're at. Elige is going to come out and find his first kill. And this is just an opportunity that I think Elige is just, you have to win this. I just don't know what happens. It's over. Alright. Not that he did something necessarily terrible or bad, it's just like, you gotta win those, bro. Gotta win those. Alright, so. Doing this real quick. One. So, we saw a lot of what Astralis was trying to do, right? Throwing some mollies here, getting aggressive B control. I mean, this isn't the best demo showing like how teams go back and forth on banana, but it shows like what Astralis's main goal is specifically against Liquid. Hey, we're gonna take aggressive B control. We're gonna get a guy down if we can. We'll send the guy back. We'll have 4A. If they can get a guy here, I mean, yeah, a lot of information. This is just the second half. It looks like Liquid wants to try and do something similar. just wears that flashbang. But that is their general game plan, right? Hold B, take control, and then go defend the other parts of the map. So, pause right here. Action. If there was more people, I'd love to ask some questions or get some questions. But that's Astralis on B. I mean, 2019, major around the corner. Maybe we'll see some new stuff from them. But obviously, we learned some things that we could take to our gameplay. Throwing two of those mollies is very simple. Throwing a deep smoke, getting deep banana control, very simple. Understanding when to peak, where people are and they aren't. But we just saw a little bit of how to play some T-side Inferno. But hopefully you learned some things. Hopefully you saw some things that you can add to your gameplay. Hope to do some more of these again in the future. Excited to do more. Always hoping to improve. So if you have any comments or feedback, I think my email is down below. Follow me on Twitter. You can tweet at me. You can yell at me. Appreciate it. But until then, I really appreciate you guys stopping by. Hope you learned something. Hope to catch some games with you guys in the future. With that, have a lovely, lovely day.